Hello, fourth class children. Good morning. In the last class, I told you lesson 3, Henry lesson. Very beautiful lesson. All of you watched that video? Very good. Okay, see the lesson 2 to 3 times so that it will be easy for you to learn questions or whatever. Okay? So, now in this class, yesterday I gave you new words also. Okay? And in this class, I want to tell you meanings, opposites, tenses, degrees and question and answers. Okay? Learn well, and Saturday you have objective online test from this lesson. Okay? Learn well. Open the notes. Open the notes. Yesterday you wrote new words, and take fresh page, and today you copy down the meanings. Okay, ma? Okay, write meanings. Fold the paper to the middle. Telusu kada meeku? Fold the paper to the middle so that all equal to's will come in a line. Okay. First one, outstanding. 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 Outstanding means very important. V-E-R-Y, very, I-M-P-O-R-T-A-N-T, important. Outstanding meaning, very important. Leave a line and write the second meaning. Slender, S-L-E-N-D-E-R, slender, S-L-E-N-D-E-R, slender. Slender meaning thin, T-H-I-N, thin, T-H-I-N, thin. Next, brandishing. Brandishing means shaking something, okay, shaking something. So, they are all going and brandishing the sticks. So, sticks tho shrabnanta vetkar kada, adi shaking anamata. Brandishing. Leave a line and write. Shaking something. Okay? Write down. Next, fourth one, lodged. Leave a line and write lodged. Fixed or stuck. Fix or stuck. Okay? Fixed or stuck. Pause the video and write, or otherwise take a screenshot and later you can copy down from the photos. Okay, ma? Next, opposites. Opposites. Fold the paper to the middle and write heading opposites. First one, easy. Easy opposite, difficult. D-I-F-F-I-C-U-L-T. Difficult. Easy ante enti, easy ga undadam. Difficult means kashtam ga undadam. D-I-F-F-I-C-U-L-T. Difficult. Next, second one, accept, reject, reject, R-E-J-E-C-T, reject, okay, copy down, accept, reject. Next, fourth one, exit, third one, exit, entry. Okay, exit, entry. Fourth one, appeared, disappeared. Appeared, disappeared. A-P-P-E-A-R-E-D, appeared, disappeared. D-I-S-A-P-P-E-A-R-E-D. EARED disappeared. Okay, appeared, disappeared. Next, fifth one, harmless. So chameleon is a harmless creature. Harmless opposite, harmful. HARMFUL, harmful. So leave a line and write down, ma. Sixth one, swift. Sixth one here I will write. Sixth one, dangerous. Dangerous opposite, safe. Dangerous opposite, safe. Okay. Seventh one, swiftly. Swiftly opposite, slowly. Swiftly opposite, slowly. Okay. So once I will read again these opposites, all of you listen. Easy opposite, difficult. Tell three times. Easy opposite, difficult. Accept, reject. Accept opposite, reject. Exit, entry. Exit opposite, entry. Appeared, disappeared. Appeared, disappeared. Harmless, harmful. Harmless opposite, harmful. Next here, dangerous. Dangerous opposite, safe. Dangerous opposite, safe. SAFE. Swiftly opposite, slowly. Swiftly opposite, slowly. 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 Okay, take a screenshot or pause the video and write down. Next, tenses. Next heading, tenses. Present tense, past tense, past participle. Leave a line and write the first one. Rise, rose, risen. Second one, come, came, come. Third one, take, took, taken. Fourth one, carry, carried, carried. So once I will tell you the spellings, all of you repeat after me. Rise, rose, risen. RISE, rise. ROSE, rose. RISEN, risen. So present tense, past tense, past participle. Like that, the next one, come. COME, come. CAME, came. Come past tense, came. Come. COME. Next. Third one, take. TAKE, take. Took. What is the past tense of take? Took. TOOK, took. Taken. TAKEN, taken. Take, took, taken. Next. Carry. CARRY, carry. Carried. CARRIED, carried. Next. Carried. CARRIED, carried. So once all of you copy down this, and later degrees of comparison. So three types: पॉजिटिव, कंपैरेटिव एंड सुपरलेटिव। आई होप यू आर ऑल नाउ थरो इन राइटिंग द डिग्रीज, यस, बिकॉज इन थर्ड क्लास यू डोंट हैव डिग्रीज ऑफ कंपैरिजन। या डिग्रीज, लास्ट टू लेसन्स आई टोल्ड यू हाउ टू राइट EREST, रिमेंबर दैट। पॉजिटिव, कंपैरेटिव, सुपरलेटिव, लीव ए लाइन एंड राइट द फर्स्ट वन, लॉन्ग, ओनली 3 degrees, लॉन्गर, लॉन्गेस्ट, लॉन्ग, लॉन्गर, लॉन्गेस्ट। नेक्स्ट सेकेंड वन, ब्राइट, brighter, brightest, third one dangerous, it's the quality of that quality, so we have to write more dangerous and most dangerous। Okay, long, longer, longest, bright, brighter, brightest, dangerous, more dangerous and most dangerous। So next question and answers, so I will explain this question and answers, but I will post this question and answers in your group, you slowly write down, okay, copy down and send your classworks to my WhatsApp number, okay। So first question, where was the chameleon, ekkadunda ma chameleon, where was the chameleon, in a garden, the chameleon was on a shrub in a garden, so first the grandfather saw the chameleon in the garden, yes or no, okay, on a shrub in a garden, all of you repeat after me, the chameleon was on a shrub in a garden। Next, why did Mrs. Ghosh scream, Mrs. Ghosh who was the principal of nursery school, why she screamed, why she shouted, because by seeing the chameleon in the papaya's basket, have you all remember the story, okay, listen, Mrs. Ghosh screamed because she was scared and shocked when Henry the chameleon popped out of the fruit basket all of a sudden, okay, Mrs. Ghosh screamed because she was scared and shocked when Henry the chameleon popped out of the fruit basket all of a sudden। Next, why do you think Henry turned a bright green, because it's the quality of that chameleon, yes or no, yes, Henry turned a bright green because of color of the papayas he was hiding in was also green, okay, once again, Henry turned a bright green because of color of the papayas, because of color of the papayas he was hiding in was also green, so what was the color of the papaya, green, that's why Henry also appeared in green color, so that Mrs. Ghosh can't identify that it was there in the basket, that's why she screamed and shouted, what danger did grandfather save Henry from, grandfather saved Henry from certain death and brought the little reptile home, so grandfather saved from that from the gardener and bring back that chameleon to the house, okay, very beautiful lesson and question and answers also very easy, and in this class I told you meanings, opposites, tenses, degrees and question and answers, so once I will go for textual grammar, this textual grammar pages I will post in your WhatsApp group, so that it will be easy for you to note down, okay, so in Henry lesson in Henry Resen, some animals they have given here and you have to identify the odd one, means remaining all the animals are belonging to one category but other one is different. Okay, I will read now. Once you see what to circle: chameleon, lizard, crocodile, sparrow. Which animal is different here? Which one is different? Sparrow. Because chameleon, lizard, crocodile, these three all belong to the same reptile category. That's why it is different. Sparrow is different. So sparrow you have to circle. Next, wasp, butterfly, earthworm, bee. So earthworm is different here. Earthworm is different. Next, ladybird, crow, pigeon, parrot. Crow, pigeon, parrot. So ladybird is different here. Frog, crocodile, giraffe, hippopotamus. So frog, crocodile, hippopotamus, these three are same, but giraffe is odd one. Giraffe you have to circle. So I will post this once you practice it in your rough book. Okay, shark, octopus, dolphin, goldfish. So shark, octopus, dolphin, these three belong to the same category and the goldfish is different. So you have to circle the goldfish. Clear? Okay, now one matching is given here, a camelog of chameleons. So in collective nouns, what we will say? Oxen, what will we say? Fish, what we will say? Cattle, what we will say? Chameleons, what? So in collective nouns, suppose birds means a flock of birds. Okay, musicians, a band of musicians. Flowers, a bouquet of flowers. Grapes, a bunch of grapes. Like that, some name we will add to that to form the collective, because for collective nouns, if they are in a group, we'll call it as a collective noun and we will add some name before that. So what names we have to add before this? Okay, listen. Here are some names given. We have to give the names to that. So what we will say if more oxen are there? Oxen. Chala oxes unnappudu em antamu? Fish. Fish unnappudu em antamu? Cattle. What we will say? Cattle. Chameleons. Rats. Penguins. Okay, now for oxen we'll say that a team of oxen. For fish, a school of fish. A school of fish. For cattle, a herd of cattle. Gumpu. Fourth one, chameleons, a camouflage. A camouflage of chameleons. Okay, next, fifth one, a pack of rats. A colony of penguins. Okay, if you have any doubt you can call me. Okay, you can call and ask. This collective nouns you once copy down in one paper. Next, so a small poem is there, lullaby poem is there, a beautiful poem. So today I completed your notes and textual grammar, and a small poem is here. So open that poem, lullaby, small poem only. Close your eyes gently. Lullaby means it's a song while singing when we are going to bed. Jolapata anamata. Okay, beautiful poem, nana. textual grammar, only two exercises are there in the third lesson, and a small poem is there. Now I want to tell you this poem also, so that we completed till now first lesson, second lesson, third lesson, and one poem also completed, and this is the second poem. What is this poem name? Gulabi. Okay, close your eyes gently, close your eyes gently and cuddle in, keep yourself snug and a new day will begin. So while sleeping, how you will sleep? Mudichukoni padukuntaru avuna kada, snug, snug, warm and safe. Have pleasant dreams about those things you love. So what you love, that things will come in our dream. Sleep is an island waiting above. Night is a blanket keeping you warm. If you close eyes, you can come to no harm. Dreams are like journeys drifting along. Rest is a present keeping you strong. So while sleeping, we feel very relaxed. Yes or no? Yes, we all like sleeping and playing. Yes or no? Yes, we all love sleeping and playing. So this idi oka jola part laga anamata, ante manam padukunnappudu mana feelings ela untai, manam elaga feel avtam, dreams anni vastayi, manchi manchi kallu vastayi, eppudaina mummy vachi disturb chesthe we feel very angry. Yes or no? Yes, sometimes, not always. Okay, repeat after me. Close your eyes gently and cuddle in, keep yourself snug, a new day will begin. Have pleasant dreams about those things you love. Sleep is an island waiting above. Night is a blanket keeping you warm. If you close eyes, you can come to no harm. Dreams are like journeys drifting along. Rest is a present keeping you strong. Okay ma, this poem also I will post in your group. So once you read this poem also. Okay Nana, enough for today. Bye, take care.